Now, the croissants are the most popular French pastry in the world, known for their crescent shape, hence the name croissant. So for this, again, we sift about 600 grams of flour. We add the flour back to the bowl, and then we add about 60 grams of caster sugar and 12 grams of salt. Now we make a well in the center, and like every good well, we fill it with 180 milliliters of water. Well, not every well is only 180, but this one has. And we fill 180 milliliters of milk. This is how French wells look. No, normie. So with one hand only, mix all the ingredients together until they form a paste. And then we take about 20 grams of yeast with the other dry hand, sprinkle it over the paste. Never add the yeast before the paste is formed. It might kill the yeast. Mix everything together now with both hands to form a firm dough. When you feel that the dough has sort of come together in the bowl, lightly dust a surface with some flour and knead it till it's not too smooth and supple, but smoother and suppler than what it was before. So once this dough is done, we put it back in the bowl and cover it with some cling film and leave it to rise for 1 hour. Now there are two parts for the making of this puff pastry. The first part is called the détrempe, which is just a mixture of all the wet and dry ingredients together, except the butter. Second part is the tournage. For the tournage, we need a sheet of parchment paper and an A4 sized sheet. We keep the A4 sized sheet in center, or a little bit to the side, and fold the parchment paper along the length to overlap the entire sheet. And then continue to fold the paper so that we form an A4 size packet of parchment paper. And we open it, take the paper out, and along the size of the A4 size cavity in the parchment paper, we line cubes of cold butter. This is 250 grams of butter. This butter is what is going to make the puff pastry flaky and delicious and you know, light and heavy at the same time. Yeah. Now what we do is we turn around the sheet so that the folds are at the bottom and the plain part of the sheet is on the top. We have to bang against the butter till it flattens out and then roll it to the length and the breadth of this A4 size sheet so that we have an A4 size sheet of butter. Here we go. Of course, the French people really don't do this every morning because, you know, the neighbors might just complain and throw them out. The best thing to do is make all of these things the night before and just bake them in the morning. But we'll get to that in a while. So once you're done rolling this into a sheet of A4 size butter, we put this in the freezer. Not the regular fridge, but the freezer. So this is the beautifully risen dough for the croissant de pain au chocolat. It's nearly tripled in size. So now what we're going to do is, we're going to get the A4 size paper again, and we're going to roll this dough out to make it 1/3 size more than the A4 sheet. So for this, I'm again going to dust the surface very lightly. The trick about puff pastry is there should not be too much flour dusted, but there shouldn't be too little flour dusted either. Hence, we're going to make use of this pastry brush to brush off any excess flour that's on top of the dough. So now, we roll it lengthwise. There you go, it's exactly 1/3 more than an A4 size sheet of paper. Now I'm sure you people must be wondering, you smart people, why we've done it. Yes, you're right, because of the butter. I'm just going to go and get the butter now. Hard as ice. Now, there are two types of inclusions for a puff pastry. The first one is a French inclusion and the second one is an English inclusion. If you've guessed right, we're doing an English inclusion. So do all the French people. At least I hope they do. In a French inclusion, you roll it out like a flower with four petals. You put a blob of butter in the middle and then close the petals and then roll it up. In an English inclusion, we're going to put the A4 size sheets of butter here and then roll half of it on and then the other half on that. So let's do that now. Dust the surface. Make sure that the opening side where you've closed, well, is towards your right. You dust it with some flour on top and roll it out lengthwise. Now you must once again roll it 1/3 more than the A4 size paper. I've done it a little bit more. That's okay, it's not going to make a big difference. And then do the same motion again. Turn the closed side to your right. Dust with some flour and roll lengthwise. Perfect. Now a puff pastry is made with 6 turns. That is 6 times that I turn it this way. But the first time that you included the butter, which is called the inclusion, is held as 1 turn. And after every 2 turns, you have to rest the pastry for about 30 minutes. So since we've done 2 turns, I'm going to put an imprint of 2 on the side so I remember. Now we're going to wrap this in some cling film and keep it in the fridge for 30 minutes. 30 minutes. I'm going to roll for the 3rd and 4th time. So here's the 3rd. Move it to your right. Lightly flour the surface, both sides. Start once again. Boy, this is fun. Feel like I'm rowing down the Thames. I could sing, I won't. And now we do the 4th turn. And wrap this in cling film and keep it for another 30 minutes in the fridge. This time I'm not going to keep it in the freezer because it's hard enough already. So we're going to keep it in the lower fridge. Remember the incisions? 2, 2, 4. And off to the fridge we go. It's time to give our 5th and 6th turn to the puff pastry. Dusting the surface with some flour and dusting the top of the pastry with some flour too. Roll out lengthwise. That's turn number 5 and now turn number 6. Well, now that the 6th turn is done for the puff pastry, the final turn is done, which means after an hour of resting, more resting time, whoop-de-doo, we shall be making fresh croissants and pain au chocolat. So we're going to cling wrap this and put it back in the fridge for 1 hour. In the fridge it goes. It's time to roll out and shape the croissant and the pain au chocolat. I'm excited for God knows what, because I've done this so many times already. But here I go once again. Now that it has been rolled out to about an inch thick, so we make this into a rectangle by cutting the length and the breadth to make it straight and not curved as this is. The first thing we're going to do is divide this into 2/3 and 1/3. The 1/3 will be reserved for the pain au chocolat, and the 2/3 will be cut into bunting to make croissants. So first, we roll out the pain au chocolat. So in traditional French pain au chocolat, the batonets are nice and thin. But I, being a big glut for chocolate, have cut out nice, thick batonets. In your face, France. But I still like you. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to roll the croissant. So traditional French croissants are not in a crescent shape. They're straight. That is if they're butter croissant. If it's any other croissant, like an almond croissant or with some other filling, like a cheese or ham or something, they make it into a crescent shape. But today we're going to do both. So let's roll away. Now this is completely off the book, but I hate throwing away these cutaways because it's such a nice pastry with such hard work gone into it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make pommier out of it, which is a traditional French biscuit that's made out of leftover puff pastry. So I roll it in from both the sides and then I cut it into these little biscuits. And then with the base of my palm, I flatten them. And there you have it. Pommier. All I have to do is dip them in some sugar and they're good to go. Now we're going to lay this on a tray that's lined with greaseproof paper or silicone paper or baking paper or parchment paper, but not butter paper. A little bit far away from each other. And now we leave this to proof for 15 minutes. More waiting time. Yippee! The croissants seem to have doubled in their size. So now we're going to brush them with some egg wash and put them in the oven at 180 for 15 to 20 minutes. We're done with the croissant and the pain au chocolat. Well, 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 look who's still here. Why don't you just watch the third part now? Fancy that? Links right below.